All right, so this episode is all about round-shaped foods. Balls is a lot easier to say. Now, this next guy calls his food gastronomic globes of goodness. Okay, so we're in the Regal, hitting the streets, trying to find one of the city's best food trucks. Now, this guy is even more twisted than I am, so I apologize in advance.
Meatyballs, guys, come get your meatyballs here.
Thanks, brother, appreciate it.
It's fun to eat food off this street. You know, some of the best cuisine anywhere comes off this street.
It gets even more fun when the chef has a ball with the product he's selling.
Nothing to be ashamed about. Even guys can eat meatballs.
Chef Phil Foss left his cozy digs at the Palmer House for the meatball. But instead of a restaurant, he's selling them out of one of the city's first food trucks.
We look like Cabrini Green, but we taste like the Magnificent Mile.
When a lot of people think of meatballs, they just think it's a bunch of ground beef slapped together with some breadcrumbs and egg, and bam, there it is. This is nothing like that.
No, we've got a lot of different variations on our gastronomic globes of goodness here at the Meatyballs Mobile. We've got pulled pork, vegetarian options, we've got seafood options, Tide balls, which is a Thai influenced meatball. And we even, by special request, we do real bulls balls.
Real bulls balls?
Yeah.
So as in bull's
testicles.
Yes.
Right.
I need my mom.
I am a virgin, but I'm ready to take a big bite. It'll be orgasmic.
Amen.
Hopefully I can say that on TV.
I can't. You know what? These feel dirty to me. Take these.
Phil's ode to SNL, his famous sweaty balls.
I was trying to figure out how we could possibly work sweaty into a menu where it would actually make some sense. And I decided to make them just really, really so spicy that they make you sweat.
Have you had his balls yet?
I think they taste great. The ingredients on them, like, to actually be serious, I can't find any of this in any store I walk in. Like,
Phil has done all of this with no marketing or PR firm. Everything he does is via social media.
It's kind of crazy what happens. You know, one person in an office will follow us on Twitter, Facebook. They'll come down, tell everybody in their office about it, and pretty soon we're having a Meatyballs Mobile in offices around Chicago.
What kind of balls would you like?
Ah, there's so many balls to choose from. It's chilly outside, so let's go with the sweaty balls.
Sweaty balls.
I know they're
nice, spicy.
Talk about what's in these sweaty balls.
This is a Tunisian specialty. This is actually my wife's specialty. There is a lamb and chicken ball that is very spicy. It's served with tomato, eggplant, and zucchini.
So we're talking, what's the spice factor? 1 to 10, what are we looking at?
Should be 9 to 10.
Really?
Yeah. You gotta make people sweat.
There's the heat factor. Yeah, the lamb and the chicken, and what are the spices in here?
A lot of different kinds of heat.
Yeah. Well, let's get out of the cold. You're almost sold out of these anyway, so let's get out of the cold, and I will help you prep for tomorrow. Let's go to the kitchen.
Word.
Yeah?
Got it.
Word.
On the other side of town, Phil gets his hands dirty. I mean, as if this story needs any more Phil. We're gonna help Chef make his signature meaty balls, the sweaty balls, and the I didn't sign up for this balls.
We're gonna start cooking off some Rocky Mountain oysters, bull's balls, bull's testicles, call them what you will.
Here are the bull's balls, testicles.
Whatever. Holy!
Right. That's one testicle that's it's gifted. And every time I slice it,
It just makes me hurt.
Phil then pan fries them, bakes them with tomatoes and peppers, and then we wait. Until then, let's make some real meatballs. Phil's wife, Kenny, is arm deep in a batch of sweaty.
This smells incredible.
Look at all the spices in this.
It's not a turmeric.
Okay, time for a classic.
These are the meaty ball. I mean, if anything could be called original or the original recipe, this one would be it. I don't put any pork inside the meatballs. What I do is I'll poach the meatball inside that pork stock so the flavor comes through.
Shut up. Really?
You know, serious.
Shut up. No. Yeah.
A little bit of the mushrooms. This is a four cheese sauce. It's made with like a bechamel base. The same kind of idea that you would do for a macaroni and cheese. Get a little truffle oil here.
Oh yeah, you're huge on the truffles.
Good. You know, I do like the truffles. Well, take me away from fine dining, but you can't take the truffles away from me.
Get ready for this. Feeling good. Good.
I'm fine. I think you're gonna like it.
Oh, I think I will too. It's a little tough.
Yeah, it's really good. Right. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Not my favorite.
All right.
Not terrible.
Right.
I'm glad to say that I tried a bull testicle. No doubt about it. But I'll take your sweaty balls over these testes any day.
I have to talk to my wife about that.
It's not all a joke. Actually, it is.